What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. In the previous video of the series, we introduced monotonic stacks, and towards the end of that video, we crafted a template that we'll be able to use to solve any similar problem. In this video, we are going to dive deeper into this template and try to solve different aspects of that same previous exercise. So, suppose we were given two distinct integer arrays where the first array is a subset of the second one. Then what we need to do is for each element inside the first array, we are going to find that element in the second array and then attempt to retrieve the next greater element of that integer in the second array. If there is no next greater element, then the answer for this element will be -1. To visualize this, take these two arrays as an example. As you can see, element 3 is located at index 2 in the second array, and the next greater element of 3 in that second array is 5. So, in the result array, the first index or index 0 will be filled with the integer 5 and not 4. This same logic is repeated on all the elements of the first array, and the resulting array will be the solution we are looking for. Now, the first solution you may think of reflects the question itself. So, you may start by iterating over the elements of the first array. Then, for each element in that array, we will attempt to find the index of that same value in the second array. In our code, after the while loop ends, this index will be k. As soon as we do, we keep looping over the integers following that element until we retrieve the first one having a value that is strictly bigger than it in the second array. When we find that element, we store it inside a new array or reuse the same slots of the first array since they are no longer needed. If no greater element could be found, we set this value to -1 and return the result to the user, which is now stored in the first array if we decide to reuse it. Okay, the solution works, but it is of the order of n times m, being respectively the sizes of our arrays. So, how do we optimize this solution? Well, we previously saw that whenever a problem requires us to enumerate values for indices based on other values in an array, then monotonic stacks are the way to go. So, how do we make use of monotonic stacks to traverse the first array, given that the value we are looking for is stored in the second array? Well, you don't. Instead, what we can do is apply the same algorithm we previously discussed on the second array without taking into consideration the first one at all. By the end of this iteration, we will have the elements of the second array stored in some data structure alongside the next greater element. After this, what we must do is iterate over the first array, retrieve its next greater value from that data structure, and boom, the problem is solved. To store the elements alongside their next greater element and be able to retrieve them later in a fast way, the best way to go is maps, as you may have already guessed. So, to implement the solution, we will start by applying the same algorithm we previously made use of, but on the second array only. When a solution or a next greater element is found, we will store in a map the original element as the key and set its next greater element to be its corresponding value. After we are done iterating over the second array, we move on to the first array, and for each element in that array, all we must do now is retrieve that value from the map and set its value to be the answer we are looking for. Finally, we return with the first array, similarly to what we previously did. That's it. Okay, with this problem solved, let's try to tackle a different aspect that monotonic stack problems may take. And suppose we are back to the single array problem, similarly to the one we had in our previous video. However, this time, that array is considered a circular array, and we are asked to find the next greater element of all our integers, so how do we do that? Well, after everything we discussed, you may directly jump to the monotonic stack solution, and say that, okay, we previously used the code we see in front of us to solve the same problem on a normal array, and from school we know that to transition between a normal array and a circular one, just throw in the modulo operator, right? Wrong. This solution won't work. You see, our iteration is limited by the for loop here, meaning we will stop looking for a solution after we go over every element once, contradicting the circular property. And even if we were to replace it with a while loop or do while loop without limiting the iteration bounds to the array, we would never manage to get out of it, as each array must have one maximum element inside it. To explain this, take this array as an example. After going through all the elements inside it once, that is what the resulting array will look like. Now, when we try to go over the elements for the second time within the same iteration, every element will be filled with a solution, except for the maximum. We will get stuck at the maximum element. You see, because we have a circular array, every element will have a next greater integer, except for the maximum, but nowhere in the code we just wrote did we mention this. And one highly inefficient solution to resolve this would be to exit the outer while loop when the answer array contains a single -1 corresponding to the maximum element. But that is not at all the solution the interviewer is looking for, as it requires a lot of time to return with the result. So, one possible alternative solution to this problem is to bring back the initial classic monotonic stack solution and keep it intact. And after this iteration ends, this code will yield to the array you see in front of you. Now, all we must do is copy-paste that exact for loop, as we saw that looping over the array one additional time will generate result from all remaining elements except the maximum. And that is exactly what we want. That is the solution we are looking for. Notice that we don't even have to push the elements we loop over into the stack again, as the ones we need are already inside it. Now, if you don't want to initialize the answer array with minus ones, one possible solution to this could be to start by retrieving the maximum element from the integers that are still stuck in the stack after the first iteration. Then, while this stack is not empty, we must reiterate over the elements of the array and apply the same exact monotonic stack solution we just made use of. Similarly, there is no need to repush elements into the stack. The difference is that if we encounter a value equal to the max number we just retrieved, we set its result to be minus 1 and skip the remaining logic. I personally prefer iterating over the array twice while initializing it to minus 1s. Which one do you prefer? Feel free to build your own solutions on top of these, and drop them in the comments below, as a lot of different approaches can be used to solve this last problem. The links to the LeetCode exercises we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.